We are going to discuss about Java being a platform independent language, right? So we all know that Java is a platform independent language, but how it is platform independent and what makes Java a platform independent language, we shall talk about it and understand. Okay, so let's look at one more here. Now when you are working on a language like C or C++ for that matter, so suppose you are using Windows, Mac or Linux or whichever machine you have, if you compile a Java, sorry, not Java, if you compile a C code or C++ code, it gets converted into an exe file, right? And that exe can only be executed on Windows machine. You can execute an exe on Mac or Linux, right? So same way, if you compile a code on Linux machine, you will have a sh executable file which you cannot run on Windows machine or maybe Mac, right? So the reason is that when you do compilation, that file has some code, native code specific to that operating system, right? And therefore you cannot have that executable running on a different operating system, which is not possible, right? So because of that reason, a C and C++ is platform dependent, right? Now Java is platform independent, and let's understand how it is platform independent. One of the biggest selling point of Java is that it is a platform independent language, right? What makes it platform independent? Let's understand. So let's say, let me take a file here. So a Java file has an extension JAVA, right? Now, why did I make it with an extension Java? So let's say if I create a file with extension docx, what will happen if I double click on that? It will open up in the MS Word, right? So for a docx file, there is an associated application which will open it, launch it, and do whatever editing you want to do there. Similarly, if you have a file with extension .java, then Java compiler takes input as Java file, right? If you give some other extension, it will not work. So you have to give a file with an extension .java, and subsequently you compile it, right? So we all know what is the process of compilations. You take a Java file, you compile it. Now what is a compiler? Compiler is a complex program. We don't have to get into those details, but it is enough for us to understand that compiler is a piece of code which will convert .java into .class and do some syntax checking, right? So in the world of programming, anything which we cannot touch is a software. Compiler is also a program or a software which does few things for us. In this particular case, it is converting .java into .class, right? Now this .class file is known as bytecode. Okay, so when you compile the code, you get a bytecode. Now you can take that bytecode and you can run it here, you can run it here, and you can run it here. Okay, so I hope you remember when we were doing the installation, I showed you that during the process of installation, there is a JDK and a JRE involved, right? So if you will go here, if you'll go to Java 8, there was a JDK and a JRE involved, right? Now JDK did the compilation, and then you need JRE for running the program. Okay, so what it means is that you can only install JDK also or JRE also. You can do installation of them independently on different machines if you want to do that, right? So you take the code, Java code, and you run here, you run here, you run here, and it will run successfully. Why will it run successfully? Because this machine should have a JVM or JRE. This should also have JVM. This should also have JVM, right? Which is able to read the bytecode and execute it. Okay, so the conclusion is that a machine which has a JVM or a JRE which can read the bytecode can actually execute the bytecode. Okay, so when we say Java is platform independent, it is only independent up till here, up till this point, right? After that, to make that bytecode execute, you need a JRE on that machine, whether it is Linux box, Windows box, Mac, or whichever it is, right? But the important part is that the Java code which got converted into .class, it could have been done in any machine as long as your machine has a JRE or a JVM to process it, to read it and execute it, you can still run that program. And this is what is known as Java as a platform independent language, or this is what makes Java a platform independent language. Meaning that, or to summarize it, there should be a JVM which can read the bytecode and give you the expected output or run the bytecode for you.